Welcome back to another video of the customs. Today we are finally loading the caddy's rear suspension. I know this has been a video that has been requested for quite some time, and we're finally doing it to actually accommodate the ride height in front. In front the shocks are actually completely trashed, so because I have plans with this car, which I'm not gonna announce, but everybody knows what the plans are for the yellow thing, I will be removing the front shocks out of the YT and be fitting it in the caddy, hopefully in the next upcoming days. But today's goal is just to balance out, or like, yeah, to balance out the weight, or the height in front and the height at the back, so we can actually get a nice nosedive, but it doesn't look too high in the rear suspension of the caddy as well. I lowered my daddy's caddy, well, it's almost 2 years ago, and I've lost a little bit of insight now to do the job. So we are going about the job and figuring out everything once again, but I'm gonna break you guys through everything because I know there are many caddy owners out there that would like to know how to lower their rear suspension, or if you don't have a caddy, you would like to know how to lower a leaf suspension. So I'm gonna do a quick explanation on the driver's side while Joe is actually busy on the passenger side. So as you guys can see, that here you have the entire leaf. With this specific pickup truck right here, you don't have a spring. This leaf spring right here actually replaces a normal spring, like example, in a motor vehicle. But you obviously still have your shock right there. I'm not entirely sure what the condition of that shock is right there. But in order to do this job, it depends how low you would like to go. So, to my understanding, with a 15-inch wheel with a 1.5 tire, if you would like a 3-finger clearance from your tire to your arch, remove the lower leaf spring. You have 4 leaf springs right here. The top leaf spring right here is the one that's actually attached to the chassis of the caddy, and this one will be exactly the same. You won't like flip this one around to nothing. The one just below that, which is the second one from the top, that one right here, that's the one you're gonna flip around. But in order to flip that one around, you will need to loosen up this bracket right here. And I don't think there's a bracket in front, but in order to flip that one around, you need to loosen that bracket up right here. So this one stays the same, the second one flips around. Then it depends on which driver's choice, owner's choice. If you would like to remove both these leaf springs, you're gonna get a nice fitment, but unfortunately you won't be able to use the caddy as a heavy motor vehicle. Like, you can't load a heavy load onto the caddy. So it will be strictly just for show purposes, just for you to drive. You can maybe load, like, make example, a few stuff on the caddy, but nothing heavy. In this kind of situation with Jody's, that we would like to still use the caddy for a load, make it look decent enough, but to minimize the chances of us getting pulled over by a traffic officer, and just to blend in, we're gonna go with a 3-finger gap from the tire to the arch. And by doing that, we're gonna keep the first leaf spring like that, flip the second one around, leave the third one in, and remove the fourth one, which is the one right at the bottom. If you would like to go lower, you can remove the bottom two, flip the second one around, and leave the first one exactly the way it is. In order to do so, you need to remove the entire leaf spring. I think I've done my daddy's caddy by simply doing everything in the caddy, like just loosening all the bolts and nuts up, and you can literally do it in the caddy, but I think it's actually way easier to do it like outside of the caddy. But the tricky part comes with these 4 nuts right here. And with this is that as soon as you remove a leaf spring, you're gonna need more thread to actually tighten these nuts right here. But unfortunately, as you guys can see, there's not thread all the way around, so you'll be needing some washers. And the last time I actually did my daddy's care, I used some normal nuts as washers, which actually worked perfectly fine. But if you could source washers with the proper diameter for this specific threaded pattern right here, you'll actually be sorted. But in our current situation, I think we might just use the same method, which would be nuts, which is actually perfectly fine, because if you tighten everything up, it should still be fine. It should just play the role as a washer. And I hope that makes sense. Just to cover up the gap, so you can actually tighten it up on the thread of these U-bolts right here. If you going to do it the right way, it's most probably recommended to find U-bolts with a little bit more thread on, or shorter U-bolts, so whenever you're removing the leaf spring, you still have that proper thread and that or lengthy thread to tighten up your nut. But in our current situation, you're going to start by removing everything. Loosen these four. Here are, well, I think two nut and bolts here at the back. I think there's one nut and bolt in the front, and that should well get the entire leaf spring removed. And then once the leaf spring is out of the carry, we can actually break you guys through all that. I know it has been a hectic intro thus far, but if you guys would like to do your rear suspension on your pickup truck, this is the way to do it on a low budget. We managed to get the leaf spring out. It wasn't that difficult. What makes this job completely easy, you just need to loosen up the shock that's bolted onto the axle, which is this part right here. I'm sure you guys will be able to see this. There you go. So I'm referring to this part right here. You just need to unbolt the shock, and this axle actually drops. That is actually busy on that side, but we'll need to put the jack underneath for support once it's loosened on that side, because the brake lines are actually hanging on here. So Jody's just gonna put the jack in the center, just to give it some, at least a little support for the center, because the brake lines are actually in the center. So just be careful with that. But thus far, only thing you need to remove, or the few things you need to remove, is loosen up the shock. There's a 19 or 17 bolt at the back, same in the front, and then you actually get the leaf spring out. One bolt there, one bolt there, and there you have the leaf spring. So now we first need to loosen up this nut and bolt in the center. Hello Luna, hello Luna, Luna, my hands are dirty, man. So we need to use a vice grip for this right here, because this is actually, this is not a spanner size, it's actually completely circular. So we need to get the vice grip right here, and it's a 16 millimeter nut on top. We need to loosen this up, get this clamp removed, these two clamps right here removed, and once those are removed, we can actually start flipping the second leaf spring around, removing one leaf spring. We need to put this back, because this is what actually centers it right here on the axle. See, right, see that hole right there? That is where this circular bolt actually lines up to. So key factor, you need to put that one back. If you snap it, rather get a circular bolt once again. We managed to disassemble the entire leaf spring. That circular bolt and that 16 nut I was referring to, that's the one that's actually keeping everything all together. What we did with these brackets right here to get the first leaf spring removed from the second one, we just took the hammer with this, let it open, and then as you guys can see, it's still on here. But unfortunately, in order for this to work, we need these two brackets on this side and that side to be removed, because we're gonna counter it's gonna be like a counterweight kind of thing for the leaf springs at the back. So this one is gonna be like this, and this one right here it's gonna be like this. That is how it's supposed to be in the caddy at the moment. But because we're only removing one leaf spring, we're gonna remove the shortest one right here. So I think we're gonna try and get this one in like this, which is gonna be a little bit difficult, as you guys can see right there. But we're gonna make it work. I think we're gonna get this one in here in the center, and then we're gonna like tighten it up. So hopefully that is not, well, too wrong. Kinda makes sense, or doesn't, I don't know. But we trying it out, because I can't really remember how we did it the first time. So Jody actually got the grind at the moment, because these brackets are actually flared on right here. So we're gonna grind off this portion right here, just like a slight portion. You have to grind like level with the leaf spring, and you can get this bracket removed on both sides. We're gonna do that real quick, and then from there hopefully we can start fitting everything back in the caddy. At the moment, Jody is actually busy installing the one leaf spring. We got it all sorted out, as you guys can see in the cinematics before this. I'm gonna do the driver side leaf spring real quick. Luna, mechanic Luna, mechanic Luna. He's installing that one real quick. The time is gonna catch us, but we're gonna see if we can get the leaf springs in and lower the car, and maybe we can just tighten everything tomorrow, so we can at least just see how the ride height is of the caddy. But I'm gonna do the driver side leaf spring real quick, and then you guys have another idea of how it actually supposed to look like. And from there, well, as soon as you're done assembling the leaf spring once again, then you can just put it back in the car. One piece of advice I can actually give you is that this center circular bolt and nut, I would recommend loosening the nut in the caddy, because it's actually seized into the axle. So if you remove it, because we had a hard time removing the second leaf spring, because the first leaf spring actually loosened up in the caddy. The second one, for some reason, we were struggling with a little bit. This one right here. And what we actually did was, we actually hit a 13mm socket on here, and actually, well, seized this one up, and we could finally loosen it up. Maybe just use some lubricant, well, we didn't have any Q20, so I just used D28. It worked like a charm. So definitely use some lubricant when you're busy with these kind of bolts, because you might just break it. And look how crusty that is. Like, it's so crusty. It's so old and crusty. So be careful. They're busy. I'm just gonna get you guys to understand while I do that second leaf spring. Another piece of advice, these pieces of materials that's actually between the leaf springs, definitely do fit it back. I think it's to prevent the not the spark, but like the two metal shaving against each other. So I'll definitely recommend this, because I think it like reduces the heat and reduces the chance of it spark ever sparking up or something like that. So definitely fit it back. Like, I think this one's a little bit lengthy, so if you maybe don't have enough, maybe just cut this one in half and just use this other section as well. Yeah, another thing. This leaf spring right here actually didn't have anything on, and not that I should know, it looks like it has been cut for some reason, I don't know why. But this second leaf spring didn't have that clamps on the side. This one leaf spring on the driver's side actually had just like a normal clamp, which is, well, where is it? This one right here, which Jody actually like hit off. No, this one right here, sorry. This one right here was on the main leaf spring, is actually tied into the chassis of the caddy. Jody hit that off, or grinded that off. Now we sort it. So the driver side leaf spring is actually a little bit more of an effort than the passenger one. So if you do attempt this job, get the passenger side done first before you attempt the driver side, because the driver side is somewhat easy. We had a slight problem on the driver side with the leaf spring. We had to use this as a spacer, and then with like two more spacers on top of this for the center circular nut. Reason being, and bolt, sorry, And the reason being for that is because the thread on that circular bolt is actually well, really rusty. And he didn't want to turn any further down, so we had to like add some spaces so we can use that certain amount of thread that was previously used with all the leaf springs in. Hope it makes sense. This side was actually perfectly fine. We got this side in, so it's literally just a bolt and nut at the back, bolt and nut in front. Then you have this bracket right here with two of these. Tighten these up. You really tighten the circular bolt, tighten up the shocks, and you sort it. Jody them just left. I'm still currently busy with the caddy. But this is what I meant with like the, well, you use a bigger nut as a spacer. This is not a very ideal solution, but it definitely does the trick, because on my carry bucket I actually used like 8 of these nuts and it still does the trick after 2 years. So let me just show you guys real quick. This right here is what I'm referring to. So the front two ones, I actually found some perfectly like seat belt, like washer spaces kind of vibe. And at the back is the ones I was referring to as nuts. Compulsory for each spacer to be the exact same length, because you just need to tighten it properly. But it would be ideal if all four spacers or washers are the exact same length and thickness. So definitely make sure of that. But you guys can see I have the same spaces on the left U-bracket and the same, well, nut spaces on the right one as well. This will definitely do the trick. This won't be a permanent solution. Unfortunately, at this time of the day, all the hardware stores are really closed. So unfortunately, we did not have the proper hardware, but we'll definitely need to source some proper hardware for this specific job, because that side I got for perfectly like 3mm or 4mm millimeter spaces, which is perfectly fine on that side. But this side, unfortunately, I couldn't find any other of those spaces around here. So I'll definitely need to run to the hardware store tomorrow or somewhat in the future to sort this out. This won't be a problem at all from my perspective. So if you guys would like to do it the backyard style, you can use a normal 17 or 19 millimeter nuts, and that should be perfectly fine as a spacer or a washer. I'm extremely tired, making a lot of mistakes at the moment, especially with talking to the camera at the moment. But I'm gonna finish the job up, and as soon as I'm done this side, I'm just gonna double check all the nuts and bolts, and we can actually just throw on the wheels and we can actually go check out how low this caddy actually is in the rear. And there you guys have it. We have the caddy finally lowered. I was liquor tied. Yeah. The previous times when I actually explained it was actually incorrect. But the way I did it today, that's the correct way that actually worked out perfectly for myself. And this is actually the third time I actually lowered the caddy. And it worked out perfectly fine. So if you guys would like to follow this method, this is actually, I'll say, 3 fingers. On a 175 tire, which is not bad. And I mentioned this in the beginning of the videos, that if you would like a 3-finger gap, this is actually sufficient funds, because I feel personally this is a perfect daily height. I think if we had to raise the carry up in front, I think it would be a nice height. It's one finger in front, but I think if I fit my shocks in here, it will actually raise the carry up a slight bit. So if you can get one full finger in there, or even so a finger and a half, I think the front and the rear will just be the perfect height. That will be all for today. I'll see you guys in the next one. If I left anything out, just comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel.